Hello and welcome to Q57. I'm Dr. Laura Murillo, President and CEO of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. We're so excited to have our next guest on, Commissioner Rodney Ellis. And it's taken me a little to keep from calling him Senator Ellis, because for so long, that's how I referred to him, as did so many other Houstonians. Welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be with you.
Well, congratulations. You're in a new role, an important role, and already working with the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce on a few projects that are very important to Harris County. So thanks for joining us, and congratulations again for serving as a commissioner.
Thank Commissioner's you. 26 Court. Years in Austin was enough. Yes. I enjoyed it, yeah. But it was time for a change.
Well, and it's a different change, isn't it?
It is.
Different change. And how does it feel in terms of the dynamic, and how is it different from being in the legislature to being on Commissioner's Court?
Because there are only five of us on the governing board of the county, I sense there's not probably as much interaction as I had in Austin, because to get a bill passed in Austin, 31 people in the Senate, 150 people in the House, a governor and all those folks to deal with.
Yes.
And we didn't have the same restrictions. So here I can only talk to one of my colleagues about an issue before I violate the open meetings law. So that does mean that I really don't have as much interaction. So this is a job where you get to work more in your silo on issues that are important to you until you get to the table to bring them out.
And tell us about the community that you're representing. How many people do you represent now?
1.1 million people. Uh-huh. You know, our region, by the way, this county would be the 26th largest state in the country. It's a separate state.
Yes.
So it's a huge region. I go from out past Intercontinental Airport, take in Hobby Airport as well. I go to the edge of Clear Lake.
Yes.
I take in downtown, the medical center, all of the sports venues, you know, most of higher education institutions in the precinct. It's a very diverse precinct.
Yeah. In terms of constituents, volume of calls when you were in the legislature versus today, what are you seeing?
I get a lot more calls now than I got when I was in the state senate.
Okay.
But a lot of the calls tend to be about city issues or about federal issues.
Okay.
Most people have a limited sense of what the city does and what the county does.
And whose ditch that is and needs
That's
to be
right.
cleaned up and cars.
But because
moved.
Of the, you know, I've been around so long in politics, so, and I try not to just tell people, call someone else.
If
we can help,
it.
We try to help.
Sure. So speaking of that, you've got a great team. How many people work in your office?
About 400 people.
Okay.
And really hardworking people.
Yes.
I inherited a great staff from County Commissioner Neil Franco Lee. We've made some changes.
Uh-huh.
I brought in a policy team. I brought most of the folks who were with me in Austin and the folks who worked in my district office. But and we found a way to blend together.
Okay.
So it's fun.
So I know one of the big priorities for the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, a lot of people out there in Harris County, is a small business program at the county. Your colleagues have had conversations about that, disparity study and others. Give us an update on that.
Well, we got room for improvement. Look, it's important to develop an entrepreneurial base in our Hispanic community, in our other minority communities, in the women's community. City of Houston passed a minority business enterprise program in 1984, 1985. State of Texas did it in about 1993. Metro has a small business program, but they don't really keep the data on who's getting to work, the port as well. But they do, both the port and Metro do have a robust small business program. I think by doing a disparity study, which means you gotta go and see whether or not you are really doing a decent job of outreach to Hispanic, African-American, women-owned, South Asian-owned businesses. And I think when that disparity study is done at Metro, it's gonna lead to some changes. The county's gonna do a disparity study as well. I think we ought to put together a small business program while we're waiting. They have a race-based program and a female-based program in Harris County. And I think we're moving in that direction. Look, as big, the county spends about $5 billion. City spends about $5 billion as well. Clearly, there are a lot of people who do business, minority women-owned businesses with the city, who don't do as well at the county. Now, some of my colleagues might differ with me on that, but we're going to know. I mean, that's why you do disparity studying comes out. But I think we could improve what we do. So
well,
could Metro and the Port.
Well, and removing some of these packages and allow for...
Don't make them so large. Break them down a little bit so that you grow that base.
Yeah.
You know, there's a reason why... Let's take the African-American community. When Mayna Jackson became mayor of Atlanta, I mean, it became the mecca for black-owned businesses in San Antonio. I mean, for a long time, San Antonio was a place that Hispanic-owned businesses thrive. And here in Houston, because, look, your chamber, that's the backbone of our community, particularly the small businesses. So we want to build on that, we want to grow. And people from those communities tend to hire their own.
Sure.
And, you know, we've got a big divide here. I mean, most folks don't live like we live. We got a serious poverty issue here. in our region. And I think by having a focus on minority and women-owned businesses, it tells people the door's open. Come in.
That's right.
Go study engineering. Don't go study political science like I did. Go study real science. You know you have a job. Study engineering.
Absolutely. And you're right. A city like Houston, we keep growing and growing, and someone's going to have to build it. Someone's going to have to manage it. And we're seeing more and more women, especially Latinas, opening up these small businesses.
And the only way we can make it, the only way we can continue to thrive as a region will be if Hispanics and if women and if other ethnic groups realize that there's a place for them at the table. We're in the most diverse city and county, one of four majority minority states in the country. It's time to do, should have done it a long time ago, but I forget about that.
Start
but
now.
Look, it put me where I am. If there hadn't been a sensitivity to minority owned businesses, my business, when I had it, which was black and Hispanic, Richard Ramirez was my partner and Jody Giles. And we helped finance the Denver airport. We moved all around the country because as a council member, I couldn't do business with the city. As a state official, I couldn't do business with the state. But I had to move around the country, and these programs gave us the opportunity to have a successful business.
And we're going to talk more about that when we come back.